Okay, everyone, week five's concepts and talk through is going to be on what we did this week, which was midfield transition and defensive shape in that midfield transition. So today, this week, we really focused on how do we defend when we don't have possession of the ball in the midfield. Some key concepts that we focused on was to keep the ball in front of you. We don't have to win the ball. We want the ball to be in front of us. We don't want them to play through. Stay connected with your midfielders. Drop first if in doubt, and we'll talk about that in a little bit, and force errors, and then calm when we win the ball back. So when we're disciplined, the other team is going to get frustrated, want to turn the ball over quickly. Then we need to be calm when we win the ball back. So the warm-up for this week was a simple exercise with players in the middle of this box in the middle and players on the outside. Now, the players on the outside, the players in red for these drawing purposes had soccer balls, and the players in green did not. In the actual exercise, they did not color coordinate. This is just so you can visualize it. And then we have the two players in the middle that will check out to players with a soccer ball and try to receive it, and then find players without a soccer ball. So working on 360-degree vision, check your shoulder, creative turns in tight spaces. So it kind of looked like this. This player checks out to a red player with the ball, receives it, turns, takes their touch back into the box, finds a new player. Same thing at the same time, this player checks out to a player with a soccer ball, turns, finds a new player. So just working on those things, checking your shoulder, you know, creative turns, looking 360 vision, that type of thing. And then we moved into the functional exercise, which was depending on the numbers and the level of player. In its simplest form is three in the back, three here, and then three in the middle. And my focus on this week, as we touched on, was defensive shape. So I'm really worried about the players in green. Now, what's going to happen is coach, I played the balls into one of the grids, and they were trying to just move the ball unopposed, trying to shift the green players in the midfield to open up gaps to play a switch ball across, which you'll see here. So what we worked on is if this player has the soccer ball, what do we do in the green? They shift over because they have to cover the end line, the split, and then the diagonal switch. So the only options this red player has is to play backwards, okay? And so that was the objective. Now, I did add a rule where a player from the opposing grid, so if this player has the ball, can join the middle zone. They don't stay there, but like a quick run in to try to move... create gaps in between those players. So now not only are these players worried about covering the gaps, but they have to be worried about runners coming in. So what you'll see in this exercise is we talked about midfield shape. So if one player from the midfield were to step, so if this player steps and puts pressure on this ball and these two players do not step, what happens is we create a split. And we do not want that. We do not want that split. So if this player were to check in and we play a simple drop pass, they get it, and now with another pass here, they just beat the midfield line. So we really want to be focused on staying connected, staying somewhat flat in a line to shift side to side to prevent those gaps from being created. And then the other thing is, so we talked about this player stepped. Well, what happens if the other two players step? We create this huge gap between our defensive line and our midline. And one of the coaching points we talked about was, do we prefer a larger gap in between our defensive line and midline or a midline and attacking line? So for example, if there's a forward in this grid, do we want our mids to be closer to the forward or do we want our mids to be closer to our back line? And the obvious answer is we don't want a big gap between our defenders and our midfield because that is a huge gap for players to make runs into and to beat us on the counterattack into these areas. So demonstrated in this is one big switch now beat all three of these midfielders when they stepped and pressed. Remember, the job of the midfielder that we talked earlier was not to win possession of the ball, rather to keep the ball in front of them. So I'd rather these players shift back and let them move the ball around and work it around than all step high, creating this huge gap. So one switch ball plays every option open. And the other thing is we also don't want to get the split like we did in this exercise, where one steps and two don't, because then we have the split there. The answer, so our starting shape for when the ball's in the middle was obviously we want to cover the mid block. We want to force them wide. Well, What happens when this ball gets played wide? If this player is in the middle or up high pressing, there's this huge gap that this team can play down the line. So we talked about this week was, when in doubt, as we talked about at the beginning, drop first. So if this player were to just come across here, the angle doesn't change from this pass. But if this player drops and comes over, look at as the angle decreases each time. And as you drop, the space between these two players becomes very, very small. So the pass is taken away. So this is the demonstration of why we want to drop and then shift when there's big switches of play along the back. Okay. Always want to keep the ball in front of us. So when in doubt, drop off and then shift, cover those angles, but be careful on how high you press. That's the job of the center forward, is to be sprinting in these spaces. And actually in the groups where we had more players, I put a defender in here to one, facilitate quicker 3-versus-1 movement, and two, act as that true game forward pressing these midfielders, okay? The last exercise everybody's probably played a version of before. This is a three-team possession game over the river, three-team transition, whatever you may call it. Essentially, there's three teams of four. We have a blue team, a green team, and a red team. The coach will play the ball into an end line, an end zone, and then what happens is we're looking to send two players from the middle to go defend, to create a 4-versus-2. Now, I didn't have any passing restriction or time restriction on this. They could play the split at any time. And the reason was I want the defenders to be engaged. I want the transition to be quick. I want the game to be played. I don't want to put rules on you not playing a split because you didn't get enough passes. I want you to be able to see it, visualize it, and make the pass at the right time. So these two players are shifting. Obviously, these two players act as that mid block now. So as the shift occurs, they have to shift to cover these gaps. If the green team were to win possession, I put goals on either ends. They look to score into that goal. So again, reinforcing that pressing, organization, and then that quick midfield transition. And so that was this week's training topic. Again, we talked about keeping the ball in front of you, staying connected, so getting in that somewhat line shape, and dropping first when in doubt and forcing errors, and then we're calm when we win the ball back. So that is week 5.